And now for our dinosaur of the day, Citipati, which was a request from Jill via Patreon, so thanks, Jill. It was an Oviraptorid theropod that lived in the Late Cretaceous in what is now Mongolia, and its name means funeral pyre lord. In Tibetan Buddhist folklore, Citipati were two monks who were in a deep trance when a thief beheaded them. And so Citipati are usually shown as a pair of dancing skeletons surrounded by a flame. It was described in 2001 by James M. Clark, Mark Norell, and Rinchen Barsbold in a 2001 paper called Two New Oviraptorids, Theropod, Oviraptorosauria, Upper Cretaceous, Djadokhta Formation, Ukhaa, Tolgod, Mongolia. Apologies if I butchered that name. The type species is Citipati osmolskae, and the species name is in honor of Halszka Osmólska, a paleontologist known for Oviraptorids and Mongolian theropods. It was found in the Gobi Desert, and many well-preserved skeletons were found, and some were found brooding on top of nests. The holotype is of a nearly complete skeleton, and there may be a second species, but it is unnamed. It's one of the larger Oviraptorids, though not as large as Gigantoraptor, which was named in 2007. It was about 10 feet or 3 meters long, it had a long neck and short tail, it had a short skull with lots of openings in the bone structure, and it had a toothless beak and a tall crest, similar to a cassowary's. It's very similar to Oviraptor, which we discussed in episode 78, and often the two are confused. In 1981, a large Oviraptor with a distinct crest was called Oviraptor, but has been tentatively reclassified as a second species of Citipati. And it has the large, tall head crest like a cassowary, which is taller than other Citipati's head crests. This skeleton was so well known it was often depicted as Oviraptor, especially since the Oviraptor holotype had a crushed skull, so it's unclear exactly what it looked like. Four Citipati specimens have been found in brooding positions on top of egg clutches, and one has the nickname Big Mama. It was described in 1999 and referred to as Citipati in 2001. It's possible that Citipati had feathers on its forelimbs. The position suggests that the feathers would help cover the nest, with its arms and legs spread out on each side of the nest. Modern birds assume a similar posture, which further links birds and theropod dinosaurs. And the discovery of Citipati's brooding changed the way that scientists thought about Oviraptorids, especially in 1993 when they found a Citipati embryo inside an egg that was thought to be a protoceratops. So instead of being egg thieves, this group shows that they cared for their young. And many Citipati eggs have been found. These eggs are oval-shaped, and they were arranged in concentric circles of up to 3 layers. Clutches may have had as many as 22 eggs, and the eggs are 7 inches or 18 centimeters long. In the same nest where scientists found the Citipati embryo, they also found 2 skulls of embryonic Byronosaurus, a troodontid, which means that Citipati may have either preyed on them, or maybe an adult Byronosaurus laid eggs in the Citipati nest so that Citipati would raise them.
Sneaky.
Yeah, it's known as nest parasitism. Oviraptorids lived in the Cretaceous in Mongolia and North America, and they used to be considered ornithomimids, but now they're part of Manoraptora. They're generally small with short skulls, toothless jaws, and crests on the skull, and they had feathers. Compared to other Manoraptorans, they have short tails.